People assume this is the woman's contribution to the relationship, which
the important part that you added was we're going to talk about it until it's done. Yeah. There are some do's and don'ts involved in that talking things out.
Yeah, that's one thing that's like a lot of people think it's teasing and it's really very barbed. So one of the things is actually Greg taught me a lot about this. Usually they people assume this is the woman's contribution to the relationship, which I think I contribute some, but Greg really taught me, has been always been very adamant about we talk through everything. Everything we talk it through and until it's done. Do you want to say more about that?
Yeah, I think the important part is actually the part that you brought into it. You know, I wanted to make sure and talk things out so there's no resentment in the air, because to me, resentment is just poisonous to relationships. We know that in our work with couples and with individuals, but the important part that you added was we're going to talk about it until it's done, because a lot of people talk about things and they think it's done, but they're both sort of still angry. They're both holding things and it doesn't go away. It pops up again. So this concept of talking about things until it's absolutely done, until there's no charge on it, is I think the most important part.
So we have an agreement about that, and people think that they think it's done, but we have an agreement that, you know, 6 months later, a year later, and go, you know, I still have a little bit of stuff on that thing. Could we talk about that a little bit? Yes, we have an agreement because, like Greg said, I've been in previous relationships where that stuff's just simmering under the surface and you get into a little snafu with the other person and it just explodes. Oh yeah, and then there was that time you said that. And it's like, we try to keep that totally clean and clear by clearing those things as they happen. And then if they're not done, I think as good personal growth and spiritual people, most of the people listening to this talk will, listening to this podcast will think, well, I talk things through. I know I used to think I did, but now I see that there's more that can be done to make sure that if we're going to live in the present moment, we've cleaned up the past moment. So it's continually checking in with myself and seeing, am I still a little bit upset about something he said this morning, or am I still a little upset about that thing from a couple weeks ago or whatever, and just making sure.
You said living in the present moment, and that's really the crux of that whole thing. So if one of us has an off mood, the other one says, hey, what's going on? Like, just my mood's a little bit off. The other person is not worrying that they're still upset about that thing that happened
this morning
or yesterday or last month or last year and spinning off into the past and getting worried.
Yep.
We're able to be here and hold space for that person because maybe they don't feel so good. And on the same token, if one of us is off, it's okay that we're off for a while. This person doesn't have to be upset worrying about what's going on with us, so they can hold space so that when we come back, we wake up after falling asleep, being in an off mood. The other person's still okay.
So that's
you enjoying this so far? Did you forget to subscribe? Make sure to do so. It takes 2 seconds. Just press that little button, the red one. You know the one. Just press it, little like. All right, enjoy the rest of this content.
So that's one thing we teach couples. I know I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist also. And then we have these workshops coming up where one of the things we teach is how do you talk things through until the water's really clear. If it's not, that's okay. But you do have an agreement as a couple that you can come back. This comes from what we would say the throat chakra, which is having a clear channel through the throat chakra. Because many people, you know, like we carry tension in here, and I often ask people, where is the tension? I'll go, it's right in here. And that is often from things we haven't said, haven't expressed, trying to keep the peace. When I studied John Gottman, who's one of the biggest relationship gurus, he said that people that often that we often assume that people that don't fight are having better relationships. Not necessarily. Sometimes people need to fight to clear the air and just say what needs to be said. I mean, there's ways to fight that are more fair than others, but just not talking about stuff, not discussing stuff, pretending like you're not upset is not necessarily the sign of a good relationship. Or just being chill and letting it all pass when you still have a little bit of charge on it.
I always tell clients in my coaching work that emotions have a beginning, middle, and end. And part of the reason for people being mentally unhealthy and personally stunted or stuck is because we have a lot of those emotions caught right in the middle, stuffed away somewhere. We haven't acknowledged them. We haven't expressed them. We take anger and we have sadness. We take sadness. We don't want to deal with it. We don't want to fight. We don't want to feel it.
Right.
So we stuff it away somewhere. And it's okay when it's up to here. When it starts getting to here, it's a little too much.
And then when it's up here, I've had it. I've had it up to here.
That's why it's also important, because you were talking about the fact that we talk things out, but we also teach people a specific framework.
Yeah.
There are some do's and don'ts involved in that talking things out, because there are mistakes that you can make even when you're just talking things out. They can just make things worse or prolong them.
Like thinking I'm always right or something like that, you mean?
Like attributing some motive to someone. You did that because. It's not a fair statement.
Yeah.
I can't possibly know why someone did something.
Yeah.
And that is an attribution of motive. It's mind reading, and you can't do that. Name calling. You know, teasing.
Yeah, that's one thing that's like a lot of people think it's teasing, and it's really very barbed.
Yeah, teasing is like tickling. It can go too far.
Yeah, like your dad. You told me your dad was like that.
Yes,
just
exactly.
Really like,
yeah.
Well, I was just joking. My dad used to do that too. Well, I was just joking. It's like, then how come I feel beat up?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Of course, you inherit those things. So I learned to be very good at teasing people in such a way that they were flattered and liked the attention. But I think sometimes they probably felt a little prick to it. It didn't feel
yeah.
good. I had to learn to stop doing that. And that's another thing that just doesn't really belong in relationships, because it can go over the line.
I'm glad you stopped that before we met.
I am too.
Another thing we really teach, so we have the part about communication, really talking about till it's done. And then I have a video called Really Until It's Done. Really done.
If you like and this another content, make sure that you like, subscribe, and comment below. And we also have amazing link right there for some cool product. I know you want to check it out. I know you want to click it. Go ahead. Come on. You can do it. All right. Until next time, have a beautiful, blessed day.